recorded myself saying hi, but I said it really weird, so hi.
For today's video, I'm doing another thrift flip or thrift store makeover. I went to the thrift store and I bought, I'll just show you. This is actually also a music box, and I thought the music box did not work, but I had this box on my floor and I accidentally hit it with my foot and it started singing the creepiest music. Is that not the creepiest song? Oh my gosh. Basically, you have to slam it for it to turn on. But the front of it is actually pretty cool. It doesn't have too much space for painting, but I thought this was really nice. I like the wood to it. I like that it has a little door, which is super cute, and this thingy. We're gonna attempt to give this thing a makeover.
Okay, here we have my hands. One finger is not painted. Don't ask. And here is the jewelry box. It's quite large and just barely fits in the screen. I think I'm trying to show you here that there are many drawers. Yes, we can see that. And now I'm moving to the top to show you I paid $5.99 at Savers for this disgusting box of hair. After taking all the boxes out, I found this little charm all the way in the back. I think it got jammed in there. It goes on a necklace. And now we're ready to clean with a packet of Pledge that matches the background oddly well. I pulled out one too many wipes, so I had to shove that one back in there. I encountered some pretty disgusting things on my cleaning journey. A disturbing amount of hair that appeared to be eyelashes, and this stain. Is it blood? I also cleaned the wood, which was not nearly as terrifying. The wood does have some minor gashes, but overall it's in good condition. I very slowly removed the sticker and it did leave a mark, but I was able to clean it off. Taking out my trusty screwdriver that I'm using for the first time here today, I'm removing all of the little knobby things.
What?
Knobby things. What are these actually called? I don't know. I couldn't get this one off though. It was stuck. Rip. And here we have all of the knobs that I could remove. I googled it and knobs is what I came up with. Please don't correct me if I'm wrong. Do not lose with an exclamation point, just so I don't lose that. My last preparation step is to take out some blue tape and tape up anything that I don't want paint to get on. I think that looks good. And now we're ready for some paint. I'm taking out some white paint. I'm using this as a base coat for the jewelry box. Even though this paint is not acrylic white gesso, I am hoping it will act like gesso and help the paint to adhere better to the wood. Lining up my boxes so I can do this. Not to this one. This one had the knob stuck to it. It required a little extra attention. Careful. Grabbing some more paint to finish up the front of this jewelry box. Once that was all done, we're ready to mix the actual paint color. A little bit of blue in the shape of a pretzel, some white, and we're mixing that together. I added some purple, and we have this nice baby blue. First coat going on. Ugh. Beautiful. I love how opaque this blue is. It looks so good. Overall, it's a nice color, and I think this is probably one of my favorite shades of blue. I went to paint the inside of the door and had another disturbing discovery. I'm scared. Here we have six annoying things to paint. Number one, the door. It had a lot of curves to it. Number two, the under part of this. Number three, all of the things that surrounded the drawers. Number four, the inside of the door. I had to avoid all of the metal parts. It was challenging. Number five, anything that was near fabric was really annoying. Number six, way in the back, I had to paint all of those crevices that were just so hard to get to. This was by far the most irritating thing I could ever possibly have to paint. It also felt very purposeless, like no one was going to see this. I avoided the music box to not break it more. Up next, I moved on to the drawers. I painted two drawers pink, two drawers this yellow color, and then one unlucky drawer purple. the drawer that I couldn't get the knob off of. I do really like the purple though. I took out my Posca paint pens. Well, they're mostly Posca paint pens. There are two Artistro pens. On the first box, I'm painting some rainbow shooting stars. These exist in the wild, of course. You just have to look outside your window at night. You can Google it. But it's actually on the front cover of Draw Your Journal, my new prompt journal. For the second drawer, I decided to make some rainbow shooting hearts because we already did stars and I didn't want the hearts to feel left out. I know they don't have feelings, but I do. The heart wants what it wants. It wants what it wants, babe. Selena Gomez. Box number three, we have some butterflies. I kind of have a love-hate relationship with butterflies. I think I might have a phobia of butterflies, but in cartoon form, they're fine. I like them and they're cute. It's just when they become real, their wings are gross. I feel like I'm on a game show. What's behind box number four? Some circles that I'm coloring in yellow. I colored that one right there with a tan color. That was a mistake, and I went over it with the yellow color. This box is by far the weirdest. I'll be honest, I had no plan. I thought I was making happy faces, but then I added squiggly lines around each of them, which made no sense to me. And then I also added little dots to each of the squiggles. Do with this what you will. I like it, but I'm also confused. For the last and final box, I decided to go with flowers. For the jewelry box as a whole, I was definitely embracing a very early 2000s vibe, and these flowers definitely bring me back. I signed my signature on the side of the jewelry box. After everything had dried, I took out my decoupage, which is literally just Mod Podge. I will say though, this is a very important step. You really need to have some kind of protective coating on top of the paint. Without this protective coating, over time, your paint could chip or crack or scratch off, which is not good. We really gotta make sure we seal in the deal. So I put this protective coating everywhere, which was quite difficult when you actually consider the size of my paintbrush. I mean, look at it, it's so small. I would feel bad for myself, but I chose this. That's a lot of surface area to cover with a very small brush, Marissa. I have a question for anyone that knows the answer. My decoupage has tiny bubbles in it. Did I not mix it well enough? Is it too old? Is there some kind of chemical reaction happening with the paint? What is going on? Yes, my do not lose bag. I'm really glad I didn't lose this stuff. We're gonna screw all of our knobs back into their rightful places in a second. But first, we're removing the painter's tape from the window. And I think I actually had my first successful tape peel ever. Would you look at them apples? Just a minor chip right there that I fixed up. And now we're screwing the knobs of each of the drawers back on. I did choose to add some highlights after the fact to this rainbow shooting heart as well as the rainbow shooting star. And now we're ready to put the drawers back in. I filled each of the drawers with arts and crafts things. I will say this was quite a frustrating project for me. I ended up spending so much more time on the preparation and cleaning process of this video than on the actual painting process. I put way too many beads in here and it got kind of jammed. But like I was saying, I spent a lot of time on preparation work this week and not as much time on the actual painting process. And that is a large reason why the designs are simpler. I only have 1 week to do these videos and I kind of just didn't have enough time to do a more complex design. Last but not least, we have bedazzles. I lost one right there. We had to pick him up and put him back in the drawer and close that drawer up. And here is what the final thing turned out looking like when all of the drawers are put in place. It does have a working door that is painted on the inside and it does close. Overall, I really like the way this came out. I like the color scheme and I like the design. I'm saying hello, or am I saying goodbye? I am. I'm saying goodbye. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next week for another video. Bye!